Okay, check this star out. Okay, it's a super much massive. Okay, so there are certain places where it goes into a different dimension. Okay, there it is. Okay, up here. Okay. So, in that dimension there, you can do that. Notice it moved up by itself. See, now it powered up. I'm just checking to make sure that it's not because it's close to the edge or anything. That's not it. It's a different dimension. Okay, so it's all about the angle. So the angle changes the dimension it's in. And you see what it does? In one dimension it looks like blinker, it's a blinker, and in the other one it's steady, like in hours I can't see it, it's so far away. Okay, so I can't see it by eye, this one's like too far away to see, but I can see it with the camera. Because I'm at a couple of 100x right now, about 300. Okay, so in that dimension, it's going to blink. Or just disappear altogether. You see it move around? It's not always in the same spot. And it just appears here, there. Like, these are big moves. When you consider, you know, its space, even a little tiny move is a long distance up there. So this is very interesting. I know it might seem boring to most people, but I just changed the dimensions and showed it on film, and how a star behaves in one dimension versus another. Okay, and I went through about three dimensions, so I showed how it behaves in three different dimensions differently in each one. And I find that very interesting. Okay. You might think I'm just a boring person, but this is like really very scientifically interesting, if I have to say so myself, because I hadn't experienced anything like it before. I've seen stars disappear and all that, but not the same star, you know, in three different dimensions all in one night. This is like a pretty new thing. Okay, you see them blinking? Now watch over here. Oh, they just move it over. It's gonna be gone. See, it moved by itself that time. You see how far it moved? It went from one dimension to another, and it still disappeared. Okay, what it wants to do, it wants to go over here, down here, and over here, where it's bright. But that is a long distance for it to cover. It's easier for me to cover that distance of the camera than for the star to travel that far. It would have taken too much energy. And it wasn't willing to, you know, to do it. It did it a couple of times, but that was enough. So you see how steady it is in this dimension? That's our dimension. Okay? Except it's too far away for me to see it, my naked eye. But this is our dimension. So in our dimension, you know, it looks steady. And as soon as it leaves our dimension, it's gonna blink. Or just vanish altogether. And that's what orbs do. That's how they do it. You see, here's a perfect example of how orbs appear and disappear. Okay, you see that? You see it move? You just saw it moving. Watch, it'll appear somewhere else. And that's what happens with orbs when we see them here on Earth. Just like that. So these are dimensional changes that occur because the orb moves from one dimension into another, and then into another, and then it comes back. And that's why you see it vanish and appear. And here is a live example of how that works, and this is a star doing it. So there is no difference between an orb doing it or a star doing it, because they're both orbs. It's just that the star has much more orbs than an orb that we see down here on Earth, because it's larger. But it's the same kind of a deal. An orb is an orb is an orb, you know? And it's just a cluster of more orbs. And this proves that they're multidimensional. And it proves that they're seen or can be observed differently in different dimensions. And I'm doing it from the third dimension, just using a camera. And that's what this proves from tonight. And that's what I find interesting. That with a camera, I was able to shift that star into three different dimensions and show that it behaves differently in each one of them. Okay, so this is an important breakthrough in terms of how we view stars. Okay, that's in our dimension. See how steady it is? looks like, you know, a normal thing. But if I move it on this angle and lock it in, okay, it's in a different dimension. Okay, it came out of it and came into ours because it's not the right angle. I have to change it. So you can make a dimensional shift using a camera and a star, okay? And the star behaves differently and it shows that you have put it in a different dimension because of its behavior. Because in each dimension it behaves a certain way. And I've done it with a camera tonight to show that, yes, you can, you know, by changing the angle, and I didn't change the distance, I didn't use the zoom at all to change the zoom, okay? The distance remained the same, it was just the angle, and it shows that the star looks and behaves differently. Different angles, because those angles point or direct the camera into a different dimension, and that's very important. That's very important. I mean, some people might think I'm crazy, but I consider this really important. It's completely different behavior when I put it down at the other end and it's in the third dimension where it looks like a bright star. Okay? And there's another dimension there where it like just vanishes and stays vanished. This is the blinker one. This is how I started in this one. It was blinking. So I think I've shown enough blinking. Now it's disappeared. Okay, I'm gonna try and make it disappear altogether. Thing that was down here. I'm gonna loosen it. Yeah, no. Okay, it blinks there too. Okay. Okay, so there's a few different angles where he's going to blink, but it's the same dimension. Or it might be another dimension where it just blinks. I think up here, it's just going to be itself. Okay, so I think that's the third dimension right there. Okay, it's not gonna disappear or blink or anything. Okay, changing color doesn't mean anything. Oh, it's blinking. Okay, I gotta raise it more. Okay, when it stops blinking and it's white, that's the third dimension. And that's it right there, I think. So here, in our dimension, it appears as a bright white star. But not in the other ones. In one, it blinks. And the second one, it was gone. And in ours, it's a bright white star. Okay, so that's the three dimensions I put it through just by changing the angle of the camera or the lens by which I was viewing it. So it's all a matter of perception. But this is exactly what orbs do on Earth when they start, you know, appearing and vanishing and appearing in different spots. And you don't know how they got from A to B and B to C and more than that. And then they're just gone. They're changing dimensions. And what they're doing actually is, in reference to you, they're changing the angle at which you can see them. Okay? And they are changing dimensions, but also the angle is changing from your perspective. So your perspective is thrown off, as well as that thing going from one dimension to another. And that's why you see it, and then you don't see it, and then it's gone. And that's what happens with these things. Okay, so that's how they do it. And when you see orbs down here on Earth, that's exactly what they're doing. Make it blink. It's a disappearing note. I don't know which one this is. I think this is a disappearing one. The right angle, basically. Whoa! Okay, that was a dimensional shift from whatever dimension it was in into the third dimension right there. That is a instant dimensional shift. Wow, you see it won't stay over there. See that? How fast it moves back? I'm gonna switch it. Let's see over here on this side. No, that's our dimension. Up here. That's our dimension too. Okay, our dimension. But up here, it's not. See that? Let's see down here. Just a touch, yeah, and the angle, just a touch, look, and it's in another dimension, it's gone. Yeah, it's very sensitive, like just a touch, and it's gone. So there's a very fine line between the dimensional outlines or borders. Now I don't know where it is. Now I really lost it. I gotta back up. There it is, okay. Okay, that's where it disappears. Right there. I'm sure it'll appear somewhere else. Okay, that's the dimension that you can't see it at all. Right there. Okay, that's where it was before too. But I There it is. I lost track of it. But that's the dimension where it like can disappear. Don't forget it's moving and the earth is spinning. So that fine line will change because of the movement. But if you just touch the camera a little bit and move it over like a hair, then you're in that dimension. You have to have a more sensitive camera, like, or me, do it in a more sensitive way than just, you know, moving it around like a lot like that. But even me moving it around like all over the place like that, I have proven that the angle changes the dimensional field. I mean, the entire dimension that that thing is in. I don't know where it is right now. Should appear somewhere in the middle. I lost it. There it is. Okay, now I have to change the range or the distance to find it. Because it had gone invisible, okay? So when it does that, if you want to find it, you gotta change the range, because the range will make it visible again. You see, when you come closer, it goes invisible. Okay, you can't see it. It's right there, but you can't see it. But if I move back, maybe I didn't move back far. There it is. Okay. Okay, do you see it? Move back further. Okay. You have to get the right range, there it is. Okay, so you can gauge it by distance to make it appear, but first you have to know where it is. Okay, and so you can change the dimensional angle and the dimensional field and even the dimension by just position. Okay, and that's what I learned tonight, okay? So the star appears differently in every dimension it's in. It doesn't appear the same, or it doesn't appear at all, okay? Or it does that, comes in and out. Okay, so that's a big lesson tonight. I know it may be boring, but this is big. Okay, if you're a scientist or anything, take a good look at this. Okay, I know I had it small and everything, but that was the only way to show it. Okay, that was the only way to demonstrate that by changing the angle and changing the range, you can gauge and change dimensions, okay? And you can do it with a star. And a star will appear differently in different dimensions. It's, doesn't look the same. Okay, in each dimension it looked different, and in one of them it wasn't there at all. It was invisible from my perspective down here on Earth. And I'm looking from the third dimension. So, I know I'm looking only at a two-dimensional screen, but nonetheless, the camera showed what the thing does. Okay, you see, it's invisible right there. But if I move it up, like if I raise it, it should appear. There it is. Yeah, I moved the camera the wrong way. Okay, this is where I should have done it. Okay, so you can make it appear like that by changing the range. Okay, but see, if you move it over, like to a different position, there, it's invisible, or it blinks. See? It's invisible. It blinks right there. And then up here, it should be in our dimension, yes. And then up here, it should blink. Okay, so down here, as far as it shows up, yeah, down here, it's invisible. There. Okay. I gotta get to the right spot. Okay, remember all the spots. Okay. It's still blinking. Nah, I lost it. That was a big lesson, regardless of, you know, how boring it was. Okay, it showed that dimensional changes can be made with a camera. Well, you could see in different dimensions with a camera. By just changing the angle and the range, and you can do it with a star. And a star behaves differently in each one of the three dimensions that I showed. In one it blinked, in another one in our dimension, the third dimension, it was bright and white, and in the other dimension it was gone. It wasn't visible. So that was this, you know, that's the lesson for tonight. And you can do it all with a camera, just from one position. Okay, just by moving the camera around. You don't have to move yourself, but you have to move the camera. So, that's a good thing to know. And that's how orbs behave down here on Earth. And that's how they seem to appear and disappear and just vanish, gone, okay? Just like that, because they do change dimensions and they're multidimensional. And this proves it right here. I did it with a star and just using a regular camera. No big deal, but a big lesson. Okay, thank you. I hope you don't find it too boring. Anyway, this was an important discovery for tonight. Thank you for viewing. This is Super Mush Mouse. It's 5 to 2. Okay, so this was a long video, but I think it was worth it because it was a new discovery, at least for me, tonight. So thank you for viewing.